Hey guys, so today I have a freshman advice video slash tips slash good things, how to make it through freshman year. I know that when I was a freshman or was going to be a freshman, I watched so many of these videos, literally like every single one that's on YouTube, and a lot of them are just like, be yourself and work hard and study. I think my tips are good, and I didn't really learn a lot of these tips until I was even like a senior. I graduated last year. I'm going to college in the fall, and yeah, so if you are going into high school, don't worry, it's not as bad as you think. It's way better than middle school, and you're gonna love it. There's just, you know, with any change, there's an adjustment period, so you gotta expect that. Also, I just got a pop socket for the first time. It's so cute. Not sponsored, I wish it was. It's like the opal one. I'll link it down below, but I love it. My first tip is to not carry more things than you need at a time. Either use your locker or keep things at home. I kept all of my textbooks in my locker, and that's the only time I would go to my locker is if I needed a textbook. And I use folders and not binders. Binders are so bulky, and you can easily organize your stuff in folders or an accordion folder. But I mean, if you need binders, use that. But I think that they're kind of unnecessary, especially for freshman year. You're gonna look a lot less freshman-y if you have a smaller backpack. If it's not like full to the brim and it doesn't look like a turtle shell. Yeah, just try to minimize the stuff. Another thing is, before you get to school, like the first day of school, make sure you go to the school's open house. Or like, you know, welcome thing, and walk through your schedule and know where your classes are. You don't want to be the freshman that's walking around in the hallways like holding a map, because nah. I mean, if you don't like remember your schedule, have it saved as your wallpaper on your phone so you can just look at your phone as you're walking down the hallway. But make sure like you kind of study where your classes are. It will just be a lot better, you know, take like 15 minutes the night before and do that. My next tip is to find out who you're gonna sit with at lunch, especially just like on the first day, just, you know, say, hey friends, whoever you have lunch with, and like meet them somewhere and walk in together. Because freshman year, I did do that, but then they like left me, and so I was sitting by myself freshman year at lunch and I cried. But like, don't worry, that's probably not gonna happen to you. Besides, it kind of might, but yeah, just talk to your friends before and say, hey, like meet up so that we can sit together. Especially if you have, I know that like my school had freshman lunch, so it was all freshmen, so it like wasn't as bad. But if like you have lunch with all the upperclassmen, then that might be a little scary. Next thing, I learned to do this like junior year, and like when you're in class and like the bell's about to ring, get out your stuff for the next class and walk like in the hallway with your stuff for the next class, if that makes sense. Because especially if your classes are far away from each other, because you'll probably get there to your next class and like you're gonna be like rushing to like get stuff out of your bag and stuff. But if you just have it before you leave your last class and walk to your next class, it's just a lot easier. And like, I don't know, if you have to like walk outside and you're like all sweaty or something, and then you gotta get out your stuff from your bag, it's just a hassle. That was just like something that I did. Next thing, get a planner. Even if you don't think that you're gonna use it, get it, or just use your phone, like your calendar. Because I know like middle schools, they gave us agendas, but high schools, they don't give you agendas, probably because just like spending and stuff. But just write down all your stuff so that you don't forget, or use the reminders app on your phone. I would do that all the time. Like, you can just say like, hey Siri, remind me to do blah blah blah, whatever, or remind me that I have a test on Friday or whatever. Or if you have to like grab a project before school, or like, you know, do something special in the morning, make sure you have a reminder, because you're like tired in the morning and you're getting ready. And I've forgotten like assignments a lot of times because I just forget them at home. So like set reminders on your phone, like use the reminder app. Okay, the next thing is really like easier said than done, but when you do it, it's great. And it's basically just don't procrastinate. And if you know you have a lot of stuff to do, like try to like just take one day of the week, probably like Monday or Tuesday, and just do it all. And it's gonna take a long time, but like you're gonna be finished with it. And then the rest of the week, you're just gonna have to do like your homework that's like assigned that night, or like no homework at all if you know all your homework for the week. And also utilize your lunch time to do homework. If you can like sit in a teacher's classroom or go to the library, because most likely you have an hour for lunch. So like you really need to be socializing the whole time, probably not. So I would just always do my homework at lunch and in my seventh period, and I barely had to do anything at home. But basically it's just gonna feel so good when you finished all of the stuff that you have to do for the week, and you can just like do other things with your time, and everyone else is gonna be like cramming on the day before stuff is due, and it's just like really nice. Also, don't be on your phone in the hallway, like, and walk on the right side of the hallway, because it's just annoying. Like upperclassmen, well, they won't like put you in a trash can, but they're gonna like push you if you're just like looking on your phone or like standing in the middle of the hallway and talking. Like you just don't, like you don't need to be talking like making out with your boyfriend between classes. I promise like you'll last 3 more hours. So anyway, okay, this is a little sneaky trick that I did, and I would always like, I would always have gum, and you know when you pull out a pack of gum, like everyone like swarms you. Here's a tip. Take a empty pack of gum with you to school and a full pack of gum, and whenever someone asks you for gum, this is like bad, whatever. Whenever someone asks you for gum, just pull out the empty pack and be like, it was my last piece. Hopefully like the same person will ask you a bunch of times in a row and like they notice, but that won't happen. Like, but it works, and it's good, because like you pull out a pack of gum and literally like 5 people ask you, and you, half your gum's gone. So okay, also if you have a teacher that you like and you get along with in a certain subject, make sure you like keep a relationship with that teacher. For example, I had my sophomore year, I had a math teacher, and she was great. Like she's the best teacher ever, and I would like eat lunch in her classroom and stuff like that. And senior year, I ended up getting a not so good teacher for math, and so I would go to my sophomore year math teacher literally like 3 times a week, and she would help me. And it's just really good to have connections with teachers in the same, in like the departments, if that makes sense, because not all teachers in your school are gonna be amazing. So it's good to kind of befriend at least one teacher, so you can like eat lunch in their classroom. You know, they'll like help you out and stuff, like they'll give you heads up on things. Yeah. Also, my last thing is to keep an emergency kit in your bag. I had like a little like makeup bag, and I had like hand sanitizer, pads and tampons, floss. You don't realize how much you need floss until you need floss. I had like, what else? I had like powder. I never applied my makeup, and I had powder. I had like mints. Like you just like want that, especially to help out your friends, because they probably aren't thinking to do that. But have like a little pouch that you keep for just like emergency stuff. You can keep like fashion tape, tweezers maybe, nail clippers. Like it's just good to have, and like you'll use it a lot. And I also put lotion in mine. But yeah, that is pretty much it. Hope that you enjoyed. Thanks for watching. Let me know when you go back to school down below. I go back on August 8th. Well, I technically don't start school until August 28th, but I move August 18th. So yeah. But thanks for watching. Subscribe, thumbs up this vid, and follow me on Instagram and Snapchat to see what I'm up to see my move to New York City, and everything in between. So thanks for watching. I'll talk to you soon. Bye.